Alright, what's up guys? My name is Danny Anime, and I'm here with JaylenHawk, and we just did a little discussion video on who we think is the better main character between Tsuna Yoshi Sawada and Izuku Midoriya, and just our thoughts on it, and kind of like just some talk between us. I hope you guys enjoy this collab video. Make sure to like, comment, and click that subscribe button, and check out Jaylen's channel too. He's a pretty cool guy. Alright, what's up guys? My name is Danny Anime, and I'm here with JaylenHawk today. Spoilers for the series Everborn, if you have not read it, and we'll be talking up to the Villain Alliance arc of My Hero Academia. The whole thing with My Hero Academia is, like, it's less on teamwork and more with, like, I guess Deku on his own and him becoming the strongest hero. In my point of view, I see Deku as, like, on his own, kind of like a Naruto character, and I feel like My Hero Academia draws heavily from, like, something like Naruto. Yes, Deku's, like, this underdog, and same thing with Tsuna, but, like, I feel Deku has a bigger drive.
Yeah, I agree with Deku having a bigger drive, because Tsuna, from the beginning, he didn't want to be the 10th boss. He was kind of different with the whole shonen cast, where he didn't really have a goal. It was more like this was thrown on top of him. He was like, no, I don't want that. But Reborn kind of forced it on him.
The thing with Tsuna is, like, I felt like he never had any true character development throughout the entire series. Like, by the end of the series, he relied heavily on Reborn, and, like, I believe it was, like, right after the future arc, like, Tsuna gets beat up by some bullies or something, and I'm thinking, like, he just took down this guy who can, like, control multiple bodies and is from parallel worlds and all this stuff, and he just got beat up by bullies and stuff, and I just felt like that's really a lack of character development, and it's, like, undevelopment, I guess you could say.
Yeah, that's actually pretty true. Tsuna did kind of depend on Reborn, which I feel like they should have killed off Reborn by the end of the series, so Tsuna can kind of grow, and then he realizes, oh yeah, I don't need Reborn anymore, so I can, like, lead this family. I can do this all on my own. I feel like a lot of people in the family kind of depended on Tsuna a little bit too much, which that was shown in the future arc, when Tsuna actually yells at Lambo and Haru, because he was so stressed out with the whole Byakuron thing.
I feel like Reborn, in a sense, was like a very heavily relied on mentor, and Tsuna really couldn't do anything without Reborn. And the thing is, Deku had to really learn a lot of this stuff on his own, and they're like, there's heavy similarities, because, like, they're both very weak characters throughout the series, but Deku, through these first couple chapters, first 20 or so chapters, really has immense character development that Tsuna, over the entire series, doesn't get.
The Guardians that got developed better than Tsuna did, like Goku Deira, when yes. He realized, oh yeah, I can't be, like, pushing everybody away, I have to kind of gather the other Guardians and then make them work together. Now shown with him and Yamamoto, when they always had that rivalry.
And Academia more covers something, like, along the lines of a lot of Naruto topics about, like, how Deku started off as nothing. He had no friends, and he goes straight into high school, and now he has all of these friends and superhero friends, and he has a quirk, too!
I don't know about Boku no Hero, but, like, does Deku get, like, random power-ups? Kind of like how Tsuna did by the end of the series with the whole weird bullet that Reborn had.
That's, like, really, like, a homage to, like, the first couple chapters, like, how originally it was, like, a comedy, and, like, he'd bust into his underwear.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
That's the thing, it's hard with Academia. It's hard to talk about that because there's very little to go off right now. We have the entire Reborn series as a whole to talk about, but the thing is with Academia, we're very limited to what we have right now since it's such a new series, but the comparisons between the two characters is really kind of crazy.
Yeah, they both had that wimpy, they didn't have much confidence, they're always getting bullied. And then something happens, and then people start respecting them, they start gaining a lot of friends, they get this new power. Though,
definitely.
Deku trained with his power, well, Tsuna's trained too, but it was like, he never wanted it. He always tried to escape from Reborn, he always tried to get away from tutoring, but then he realizes by the end of the series that Reborn was sort of his savior.
And you see, that's like a big flaw with Tsuna, and the good thing about Deku is, like, Deku had the drive to do it, he just never had anybody to teach him. While on the other hand, Tsuna did have somebody to teach him, but he didn't have the drive to want to do it. And
that's true.
They're kind of opposites right there, but, like, if Deku had had somebody like Reborn, he would have taken advantage of that. The thing is, though, Like, I don't understand why Tsuna wouldn't want that power if he knows he's getting involved in this mafia world, and there's going to be people who are going to want to kill him. Why not try and get on top of that and take that power?
The manga author was trying to go for was Tsuna's like a normal kid, like the normal kid in this situation where he's like, wait, there's a mafia? I don't want to be a part of that. I don't want to die. I don't want to lead a big group and all that stuff. And you're right, Deku would take advantage of that, and Tsuna, honestly, not trying to seem kind of mean about it, but Tsuna was a
He was at points, bro. He was, and it sucked. Like, I really like Tsuna as a character, and the entire time, I thought after the anime ended, I thought, like, okay, manga's probably gonna have some good stuff going on, and, you know, he'll have, like, some good character development, and I'll have, like, some closure with the series, but I really felt like I didn't have any closure.
I would probably say that anime ending, like after the future arc, was a way better ending compared to the manga.
Because
it felt like it was getting dragged on. That and the whole last arc was rushed because Shonen Jump was canceling the series, which I believe it did get canceled a few times before that. I kind of realized that a lot of them didn't really respect Tsuna.
That's the thing with like Hitman Reborn. They're all kind of thrown together forcefully, just like, okay, you're all a team now. And yes, that's a bit of a shonen trope, but I feel like Academia does a better job of it. Like, even though, like, we're only talking about the first 20 chapters, it still felt like there was some relationship between all of the characters, and they weren't just thrown together as a team. And then when the arc ends, they all split off in Reborn. Well, on the other hand, Academia, they're all friends outside of school and stuff. They all have each other's numbers and all that stuff, so there's better like character relations there in Academia, but I guess what I'm trying to say with Reborn is those character relations aren't as solid.
And like even with going with like some of the similarities between Tsuna and Deku, it doesn't have that drive like you're saying.
Mm-hmm.
He like what was Tsuna, like did Tsuna even have a goal? He didn't really have a rival.
Not
I guess you can kind
really
of say
at all.
I was thinking, and another similarity that they do have is the fact that they will protect their friends no matter what. But that's just like kind of like a shonen trope, I guess. Like even though they know that they might not have enough power to do so, they go ahead and do it like Deku did for Bakugo in the second episode.
Yeah, definitely. And I guess overall, between the two characters, they are wimpy characters, but I feel like Deku overall, in my opinion, is the better character between the two. He has better character development, and Tsuna doesn't have good character development. Now, this is only looking at the limited amount of Academia we have. We have not seen all of Academia, but from what we have seen, definitely I feel like Deku has more character development. Because, like, he becomes this strong kid, and he has this drive to keep going. Well, throughout the entire series, Tsuna never develops a drive throughout all of these chapters, 400-plus chapters, and only in these 80 chapters we have so far. And what we're talking about is he has the better drive overall.
I still like Tsuna. He's still probably my favorite anime character of all time, but I do agree with the fact that he wasn't developed as good as he should have.
Anyways, guys, what are your thoughts? Who do you guys like better? Do you guys like Tsuna? Were you guys a fan of Hitman Reborn? Did you wish it would have had a better ending? Or are you guys Academia fans? I know I am definitely an Academia fan. And Jaylen, thanks for coming on my channel. I hope we can do more of this. And any final thoughts?
Nope, that's all, Danny.
Awesome, yeah. Thanks for coming on the channel, and peace out, guys.